Hello. Let's create a futuristic scene of a laboratory experiment. To create textures, we need the J-Splacement program. The link is in the description. We use it to generate the sci-fi HUD and the texture for the plane. Create a couple of metaballs and place them. Then create a container from a cylinder. You can smooth the edges using Ctrl plus B. Create a plane and a camera. Use a large focal length for the camera. I will use 165 millimeters. Create a particle emitter for the pills. Any low polygonal object will do, such as icosphere. Now let's create the pill itself. Create an icosphere with lots of geometry. Pull back the top hemispheres and you have what you need. For the bubbles inside the metaballs, create a UV sphere. Place it under the plane. Let's organize the lighting. For this scene I used point lighting. Convert the metaballs to meshes. I suggest reducing the geometry on them with the decimate modifier to better optimize the scene. Repeat after me the creation of the particle system. If you don't want the particles to come out in some places, then copy this object, shrink it. And on the render and viewport display tabs, uncheck the show emitter option. Next, let's create a system for the pills. Let's start creating materials. The first material for metaballs. For cleaner glass material in the viewport display tab, I advise you to turn off the shadow ray display. Now create for white particles inside. Let's start creating the material for the pills. Then the container. Our scene is already looking pretty cool. But it lacks atmosphere and immersion, so in order to show that this is really a laboratory or something like that, let's create HUDs. The link to this program is in the description. Generate any futuristic patterns you want. Just a humble bounty hunter, man. Play several planes on the scene. In the material setting of each of the planes, set these futuristic images as the texture. To make them transparent, use these nodes. For the plane on which the whole scene stands, I also created a texture in this program. Use different generators to achieve beautiful results. That's all for now. Thanks for watching. I encourage you to check out my other tutorials.